By the very nature, transactions are distributed. At each node, the transaction manager is responsible for all the client-server interactions that touches that particular node. For example, the client at this node could have done the following. It could have opened the window for reading Gmail. It could have opened a window in which he is accessing a file for editing. Now, the transaction manager at node A has to manage the transaction trees corresponding to each of the client-server interactions that is initiated by this client. Opening a window for Gmail is one interaction. Opening another window, which is accessing a file for editing, is another interaction. The transaction manager is responsible for maintaining the transaction trees for each one of those separately. And the transaction manager, where the client-server interaction originates, is the owner as well as the coordinator, but it is designatable to some other node, as I mentioned already. And there is a graph structure for the transaction tree. And this is very useful in terms of reducing network communication because all the transaction managers that form this interaction don't have to always communicate with the coordinator. For instance, the transaction managers at node C and D have been contacted because of IPC that originated at node B to node C and D respectively. In that case, they only have to report to node B and they don't have to necessarily report to coordinator of the whole transaction tree. So this is helpful in reducing the amount of network communication. All transaction managers are not equal. I mentioned earlier that brittle nodes in the system are the client nodes, and therefore it is possible that a transaction manager that originated at a client node may designate the coordinator to be a more robust node, like the file server. And there are different kinds of failures that can happen. There could be a failure of a participant node in the transaction, or there could be a connection failure, or it is possible that one of the subordinate transaction manager failed to report. All of these are sources of failure. Now, one of the things that the transaction manager at each node has to do is to log periodically to persistent store state that is created on behalf of the client or on behalf of the server. Whatever is happening at that node, this transaction manager is responsible for creating checkpoint records for recoverability reasons. And these checkpoint records will be useful for warding off against failures or partial recovery of work. So in a distributed system, failures can happen at any point. If, for instance, this node fails, then the transaction manager at this node has also failed. And this is something that this transaction manager is going to find out about because it doesn't hear any response from this transaction manager. But a transaction represented by this graph here is not aborted at the first indication of failure of a node. And the reason is because you don't want error reporting to stop as a result of failure. You want the transaction to be aborted only upon termination as requested by the transaction manager, the coordinator of the transaction tree. And the reason is, as I said, to make sure that partial failures, they may have left states. You want to clean up all of that, and that will happen when the coordinator initiates termination of the transaction. We'll see that in a minute.